So, if you talk about the time value of money, how much you are investing and how much rate of return you are getting, the time and value of money, time, how many years you are investing for that, how much value of money is been increasing, how much time and how much value of money is been increasing, what is the rate of interest? At what rate the investment is been increasing, return has been increasing. That's why we are going to discuss about the time value of money. The concept of time value of money, in this we are going to discuss about the future value, that is compounding, and the present value, that is discounting. We'll discuss what is this future value, what is this present value now in the coming slides. And the present value, future value, these are the two the basic criterias to value or to find the value of investment. So we see one by one. The interest rate, I already told you that the interest rate which we get the return on our investment. So you tell me, which one would you prefer? Which one would you prefer? Say, for example, birr. 10,000 birr today or 10,000 birr after 5 years. Which one would you prefer? Anyone? Which one would you prefer? You want to take 10,000 today or you want to take 10,000 after 5 years or after 1 year? Which one would you prefer? Anybody, unmute your mic and you can tell me. ₹10,000 birr today or ₹10,000 birr after 5 years? Which one would you prefer? Your voice is not coming, Milash. Unmute your mic. Unmute your mic.
ምላሽ በሁለት ነው የገባ እንዴ?
አይ ቲንክ ኢዝ ናት የስ 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 ሚላጅ ዊች ዋን ውድ ዩ ፕሪፈር 10,000 ቱዴ አር 10,000 አፍተር 5 ኢየርስ
10,000 ቱዴ አይ ውድ ፕሪፈር
ዋይ
ቢኮዝ ኦፍ ዘ ቫሊ ኦፍ ዘ መኒ it's different from today and after 5 years.
After 5 years.
Yeah.
Because if you receive 10,000 today, you can invest. That money makes money, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
Money makes money. This concept is a little less in Ethiopian community because they are not investing. They are not investing. The most interesting thing is that if you want to become rich or if you want to earn more money, your money has to make more money, not you. If you are making money, till the end of the life, you have to make money. If your money is making money, if your money is making money, if money, your money is starting making money, that will you work or you don't work, but your money work, because that is called investment. Because your money has to work more, your money has to work more. So that's why if I ask this question, everyone may prefer 10,000 today, because this 10,000, if I receive today, I can invest today. From today onwards, my money starts working. And my money makes returns from today. Yes. So yes. Like this, yes. it is a time value of money. The time, if you see this 5 years after 10,000, if you receive 10,000 after 5 years, if you receive these 5 years value of money, you are losing. You are losing the chance of investing opportunity. That's why, everyone will prefer 10,000 bir today rather than selecting 10,000 after 5 years. That is what I want to convey, that a time value of money, value of money is important. So that's why I already told you that obviously you may select 10,000 today, 10,000 today, because you are already recognized that there is a time value of money. You are already recognized that there is a time value of money. So that's why the time value of money that will define what is the meaning of this time value of money. What is the meaning of this time value of money? We'll discuss that. Here there is a bill received today is worth more than a bill received tomorrow. This is what the concept of time value of money. A bill received today is worth more than bill received tomorrow, because there is a chance. This is because bill received today can be invested to earn interest, and the amount interest earned depend upon the rate of return that can be earned on the investment. So that's why if you invest today, your money starts working, and that money can be invested, and it can make some returns for this. So that's what. So the time value of money quantifies that value of bir through time. Value of bir through time. Through time, how much value of bir we are getting through investment. That is what the concept of time value of money we are going to discuss. So that's why the time value of money introduction, if you see, the concept of TVM. TVM means, you remember that shortcut, time value of money. Time value of money shortcut. And if you take this this thing, the concept of TVM refers to the fact that money received today is different and worth from the money received sometime in the future. That's what I want to convey, that. And today's bir is bir has more value than tomorrow's. Whatever the money you are receiving today is more value than the money that you are receiving tomorrow. That's why the time value of money. The concept of TVM, time value of money, is applicable in a equal strengths of individual as well as business. This concept is, this time value of money is applicable even for individuals as well as the business. Because some businesses, they'll invest very small, very less time period, they earn more. They get returns more. Some companies, they invest huge money for long time in their projects, but returns would be very less. That's why, how much time you are investing, what is the value of money has been increasing. So time is important, and rate of return is important. Time and rate of return is important. So why there is presence for money, importance of TVM. What is the importance of TVM, time value of money? One thing is that future is uncertainties. Future uncertainties, risk and uncertainty. Because if you want to get money after 5 years, is there any guarantee that after 5 years you get money? Do you believe the future? Future is very uncertain. So that's why we have to prefer today. The future is very uncertain. That's why we have to prefer today. That's why we can say that there is a value, there is importance for time value of money, because of future is uncertainties. And immediate consumption. If you get the money today, you can start from today itself investing, or you can consume today. You can utilize that money from today. So that's why there is one thing, that immediate consumption is possible because of your time value of money and reinvestment opportunities. Whatever you are invest, whatever you are getting today money that you can invest immediately. So reinvestment operation. And one more thing is that inflation. You know, inflation day by day. Inflation has been increasing in Ethiopia. Nearly 11 to 12% inflation is there. So to beat that inflation, to beat that inflation, we can get the money today. Today, if you invest today, so the money can get the returns. That returns can be overcome the inflation. That returns can be overcome the inflation. So that's why in capital budgeting decision, whether China is investing. Many projects in Ethiopia. They are constructing the airports, they are constructing the roadways, they are constructing the railways, dams. So without doing estimating the time value of money and returns, are they investing? No. They are doing this capital budgeting decision. This project is profitable for us or not? In the future, it is profitable or not? So they calculate the time value of money and they are investing here. So like that, there is importance for this time value of money. And I already told you that time value of money can be calculated in following ways. Time value of money can be calculated in following ways. One is that future value, that is compounding. Future means in the future, today if you invest first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. So like this future, the compounding interest may get increases. Okay. The present value means discounting. I'll tell you this, what is this present value and future value. Here I gave an example here. If you take one example here, I have given you here is that the present value is unknown, how much you are investing. But in the future, you are getting a $100 at the rate of 6%. They are saying that at the rate of 6% for seven years, the future value is $100. So how much I should invest to get $100? Anybody? How much I should invest? The future value is 100, but your friend is telling that at 6% interest, 7 years if you invest, you'll get the future of $100. But how much I should invest present? How much I should invest in present? How much I should invest today? Okay, anybody? How much I should invest? I'll tell you this calculation. We have a formula for that to find the future value or the present value. To find the present value, we have the formula. That's what I want to ask you. I want to tell you that you think of it. Try to understand the concept of present value and future value. Try to understand the concept of present value and future value. So like this, so that I'll tell you that formula, how to calculate that. And present value, what is today's value of tomorrow's cash? Understand? What is today's value of tomorrow's cash? Tomorrow, how much you are getting? $100, yes? $100. But what is value of today? How much I should invest if I get $100 in the future, tomorrow after 1 year, well, how much I should invest? They are saying that 6% interest and 7%. Like this, future value means what is tomorrow's value of today's cash? Today, say for example, I am investing $500. If I invest today, what will be the future value? What will be the future value? So try to understand this present value and future value. We do the calculations. We have formulas for that. and present value, what is the today's value of tomorrow's cash? I can say that the present value is also called as a past value. Past value means how much we invested, and in future how much it is increased. Don't get confused. So that's why present value means just you remember this. What is today's value of tomorrow's cash? And future value means what is tomorrow's values of today's cash? Today, if I invest $500, how much it would increase in the future at the certain rate of interest and certain period of time? So let's see. I'll see this value. So the future value, already I told you that the future value, that is compounding, means today you invest year 1, year 2, year 3, interest you may add, yes? If interest, say for example, $100 you invested at the rate of 10%. Yeah, so 110% means $10. So first month $10, second month $10, third month $10, like this compounding, yeah? You believe or not? The seventh or eighth, ninth wonder in this world in finance is that compounding. Because if you invest today, that money makes more money periodically. That's why invest early. Most of the people, when they start investing in various components, they start after 35, after 40 years. No, that is not the right way. The moment you start earning, start investing, that gives the compounding value to your money. That gives the compounding value to your money. You teach to your children also. You teach to your children, start investing from today. The moment you start earning, immediately you should start investing so that money makes money. Will add the value of compounding. That will add the value of compounding. So that's why the future value of sum of may be defined as value of money increasing in the future. The future sum we are calculating in the future value. For example, here I gave. For example, 1,000 invested at 10%.
Hello.
Yes.
Manulingar.
Milash, you mute your mic.
Is that another salasand? Is it?
Right. So, for example, the bir 1,000 invested at the rate of 10. After 1 year, the amount would be 1,000 bir plus 100. Total 1,100. That is the future value of present value. What is the present value today? 1,000. Okay. What is the present value today? 1,000. What is the future value of that present value? 1,100. Because you are investing at 10% for 1 year. That's why try to understand this concept. Try to understand this concept. So 1,000 is the present value. 1,000 is the present value that you are investing today at a 10%. After 1 year, your future value would be 11,100. In our example, we don't know this present value. Means we don't know this, how much we are investing. Yes? We don't know this. So that's why we can calculate that also. So 1,000, if you invest, this is present value is 1,000. 10% is the rate of return. And 1 year is the time period. And the amount would be, at 1 year, 10% interest means $100 you may get. Total future value is 1,100. It is compounded every year like that. Every year 100 will increase. That is the value of compounding. So that's why the 1,100, this we can say that the 1,100 is the future value of today's 1,000. This is present value, yes? This is present value at 10% interest after 1 year. So this is what one concept we can say that present value. Present value means compounding, discounting. Which value is great, future value or present value? Which value has more value? Present value or future value?
Value.
Yeah?
Future value.
Yeah, future value means present value is discounting only. There is no interest. That's why we are discounting. Yeah.
Yes.
That's why. So try to understand that concept. So the present value of a future money is defined as the value of that money was received today. Today, that whatever the money we have, there is no value for that. So, for example, present value of beer 1100. This is a future value in a previous calculation, in previous example. 1100 receivable after 1 year. After 1 year, beer is 1000. Okay, that is what the 1000 is the present value. So the present value is discounting. That's why present value do not have any value added. That's why we are discounting. Okay, so that's why this example I have given. Just you read this example, and if you see this present value, that's why we can say that. This is present value 10,000 here. You are investing. One first year, second year, third year. Okay. 10,000 present value plus interest. Yes. This is future value compounding. This is future value compounding. Say, for example, if we receive this 10,000 after 3 years, if we receive this 10,000, same 1,000 after 3 years, what you are losing? You are losing the interest. Yes. You are losing the interest. If you receive today 10,000, then you can invest and it can add some interest. But you are not receiving this 10,000 today. After 3 years, you are receiving this 10,000. So you are losing the interest. That's why 10,000 minus interest. That is what discounting, we can say that. That's why value of money today is more important than value of money tomorrow. Whatever the value we receive today is more worth than the money we receive in the future. That's why today try to receive and invest so that it will add some interest to you. If you don't receive today, if you receive tomorrow after 1 year, after 1 month, you lose the opportunity of investment. You lose the opportunity of interest. That's why we can say that discounting. So like this, we can calculate this. Future value and present value. The future value, present value, these are the formulas to calculate. These are the formulas to calculate. Right. What is the formula? Present value is equals future value by 1 plus I power of n. Okay, R future value. This is a formula. Future value is equals present value times 1 plus I power of n. These are the present value, future value formulas. Here, the PV means present value, FVV means future value, 1 plus I means interest rate. I means interest rate, N means time or number of years. Time or number of years. So to calculate the present value, future value, these are the formulas. These are the formulas that we are taking. So we calculate this. Say for example, question. At the end of the third year, what amount we will get and what will be the future value of 10,000 at the rate of 4.5% uniformly. 4.5% uniformly. Okay. At the end of the third year, what amount we will get? Means we have to calculate the future value. Yes. We have to calculate the future value. What amount we will get in the future value of 10,000 at the rate of 4.5%. Okay. Okay. This is 10,000 is the present value. Yes. 10,000 is the present value. Yes. They are asking us to calculate the future value. So what is the future value formula? What is the future value formula? Future value calculation, PV times 1 plus I power of n. Yes, this is a formula. Now, therefore, PV is equals 10,000. Present value is equals 10,000. I is equals interest 4.5%. N is equals how much they are saying? Third year. Yes, 3 years they are investing. So N is equals 3 years. So therefore, future value is equals 10,000 times 1 plus 4.5 by 100. You have to take 100, 4.5 by 100 means 0.045 power of 3. Okay, this fraction, the power of 3. So if we calculate this, how much we are getting? How much you are getting? 11,411.66 at the end of the third year. Understood? This is the future value. This is the future value. I think time is getting up. I think this is the future value. So this is present value. How do we calculate the present value? Already we know the present value. How much is the present value? 10,000. Yes. Then this present value can be calculated like this. So PV is equals future value by 1 plus I whole to the power of n. Already we know, but again, if we calculate, we'll get 10,000 here, present value. Present value, discounting from the future. In the future, you'll get 11,411, but present value is 10,000, yes? The same formula, you can apply this for our first example. The same formula you can apply for the first example. Okay.